Hello student, today's topic is abiotic pollinating agents and adaptation for anemophilia and hydrophilia. Anemophily means pollination by bean. Here this large number of pollen grains they are carried by bean, and when pollen grains they are carried by water, it is called as hydrophily. Let's see in detail. You know that pollination is of two types, that is self and cross pollination. Then this pollination, it is carried by different agents such as abiotic factor or abiotic agent and biotic agents. Abiotic means non-living, these are wind and water, and biotic agents are bird, insect, bat, then ants, snail, etc. The agent responsible for pollination have been grouped into two main categories. Which are these two categories? Abiotic agents and biotic agents. Abiotic means non-living agents, which include wind and water. Here we are discussing these abiotic agents. Pollination by wind, it is called as anemophily. Most of the important crop plants pollinated by wind, these are wheat, rice, corn means maize, then rye, barley, oat. Palms are also wind pollinated, and you know that gymnosperm, they are also wind pollinated. This is inflorescence of wind pollinated plant. Flower of this plant show adaptation, such as flowers, they are small, inconspicuous, colorless, without nectar and fragrance. Here this is inflorescence, it contains thousands of flowers. See, these flowers, they are very tiny or small, or they are inconspicuous, and they are not attractive like the flower of rose or China rose or lotus, etc. And they do not produce nectar, that is a sugary substance, as well as scent or fragrance or smell. Here single enlarged spikelet of this plant it is shown. The pollen grains are light in weight. Here pollen grains, it is smooth, which it is without any ornamentation. Here you know that in case of insect pollinated plant, pollen grain they are spiny, but here pollen grain they are smooth, then they are light in weight, and they are producing large number, as there may be wastage of pollen grain due to unfavorable direction of wind. Suppose one plant is here and another plant is here. Means direction of wind require like this or like this for pollination. But if the direction may be unfavorable, at that time large number of pollen grain they get wasted, and to avoid this, large number of pollen grains they are produced, and they are powdery and dusty, and they are light in weight, so they are easily carried by wind. Next adaptation, the stigma is feathery. See here, this is the stigma of one flower, this is stigma of another flower. Here the stigma is feathery like this, so pollen grain they are easily catch by this feathery stigma. Next adaptation, stamens are exerted, means they are exposed. These are stamens with long filament and versatile anther. Why they are exposed? Because their filament they are longer. Filament they are longer, and they are with elongated anther and versatile anther. Means this anther, it is attached to connective by a point here, so it freely hang in the air. See here, this stigma and anther, they are exposed to air current, so pollination become easy. Next we will divide it. First flower, they are not attractive. Second, without scent or nectar, then stigma, feathery, anther, they are versatile, then pollen grain, they are smooth, they are powdery, dusty, and they are produced in large number. These are adaptations shown by anemophilous flower. In case of maize plant, anemophily is same. Here, male inflorescence of maize plant is called as tessar and female inflorescence is called as ear. Male inflorescence is at the apex of plant and female inflorescence located to the base. Next topic is pollination by water. It is called as hydrophily. It is found in only 30 genera of aquatic monocot. Example, Vallisneria and Zostera and Ceratophyllum. Here, similar to the anemophilous flower, flowers of this hydrophilous plant, they are small and inconspicuous. Next adaptation, perianth and other floral parts are unwettable. Perianth means when sepal and petal, they are not differentiated, they are similar. That whorl is called as perianth. And individual member of that perianth, it is called as tepal. Here, all these floral parts, they are unwettable. Next, pollen grain, they are long and unwettable due to presence of mucilage. Pollen grain, they are like this. Next, nectars and fragrance, they are lacking in flower. Next, it is of two types, that is hypohydrophily. Hypo means below. When pollination occur below the surface of water, that pollination is called as hypohydrophily. Here the pollen grains, they are heavier, so they sink down and caught by stigma of flower. Example, Zostera. It is also called as seagrass, means it is a marine angiosperm. See, this is the most important point. Zostera, it is a marine angiosperm. Here pollen grains, they are long, ribbon like, without exine. Here exine is absent. Next type, that is ichthyhydrophily. When pollination occur on the surface of water, it is called as ichthyhydrophily. Here pollen grain float on the water and reach the stigma of flower. Example, Vallisneria. Here this Vallisneria, it is dioecious plant. Dioecious means male plant is different and female plant is different, or unisexual condition is there. Human beings are also dioecious animal, means male is different, female is different. We are unisexual. In the same manner, this Vallisneria is unisexual. Here, male flower, they float on the surface of water. Then, female flower, at the time of fertilization, they come to the apex. And after the fertilization, their pedicel again coil, means their stalk get coil, and they go to the bottom of the plant. Means before the pollination, they are at the base. At the time of pollination, they are at the apex, and again they go to the base after the pollination. See, here Vallisneria is submerged dioecious freshwater aquatic plant. Zostera is marine plant, Vallisneria is freshwater plant. Then female flower reach the water surface temporarily to ensure pollination, and male flower float on the surface of plant. Here these male flower, they float, and female flower come to the surface of water for pollination. Same diagram is here. Male and female plant means dioecious condition, or plants they are unisexual. Male flower, they are floating here. In this Vallisneria, specific gravity of pollen grain is equal to that of water. So this pollen grain, they float on the water surface. All aquatic plants, they are not hydrophilous. Some aquatic plants, they are anemophilous. Example, Potamogeton and Halogaris. Next, some aquatic plants, they are entamophilous, means they are pollinated by insects. example lotus, water hyacinth and water lily. Though they are present in water, here the pollination occur by insect. We will revise it. Wind pollinated flower, example grass or rice, wheat, maize, jowar, etc. Scent is absent, flower small, not attractive, nectar absent, anther versatile, exposed, then pollen grain they are smooth, light in weight, then they are dry, powdery or dusty and they are producing large number, stigma large, feathery and exposed. Pollination by water, it is called as hydrophily. When it occur above the surface of water, it is called as epihydrophily. Example is Vallisneria, and when it occur below the surface of water, it is called as hypohydrophily. Example Zostera. And water pollinated flower, they are not attractive, they are inconspicuous, nectar and fragrance absent, pollen grain they are light, unwettable, they are covered by mucilage covering and they are without exile. These are characteristics shown by hydrophilus flower. Thanks for watching.